There are Senators Lindsey Graham, Charles Grassley calling for an investigation into that British spy. Here is what was said just the other day.
So I want a special counsel to look at not only how Mr. Steele conducted himself, what the FBI did with the dossier, whether Mr. Orr, whose wife worked for Fusion GPS alongside Mr. Steele, what involvement did he have in the dossier? And I want to find out if the lead investigator of the Clinton email investigation had a political bias against Trump for Clinton to the point that it was a sham investigation.
He said a lot. Judge Andrew Napolitano, Fox News senior judicial analyst, back from his small break, short break. Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Happy New Year to you.
Do we need to investigate
Christopher Steele? Start there.
Well, Senator Grassley makes a very good argument, and we can't really evaluate the argument because some of the information that has come to him has come in a secret capacity. So he says he has seen things which are at odds with what the FBI says Christopher Steele told them. So that would mean in his mind, and we haven't seen what he has seen, and he can't share it with us, but he can share it with the FBI, that Steele lied to the FBI. If so, this would be the same crime that General Flynn has been indicted for. If you read the statute carefully, it says lying to the FBI such that it interferes with the FBI's work. So if the FBI knows you're lying to them and it doesn't interfere with your work, is that a crime? Did the FBI know he was lying at the time he said whatever he said that Senator Grassley says is a lie? The other tape from Senator Graham, I agree these things should be investigated. Did the FBI carefully investigate Mrs. Clinton, or was the fix in from the beginning? But I do not believe we need a special counsel. The special counsel rule exists for when there is a conflict between the Attorney General and something happening in the Justice Department so that he, the Attorney General, cannot manage it, and you need an outside manager like Bob Mueller to manage it. The reason we have a special counsel for Russia is because Jeff Sessions, when he was Senator Sessions, played a leadership role in the campaign. He can't manage the investigation of the campaign when he's probably going to be a witness. But he can certainly manage the investigation of what the FBI did and didn't do when they were investigating Mrs. Clinton.
Okay, I need a flow chart. I'll slow you down just a moment. You are arguing then is that we don't need an investigation to investigate our government.
No, I am saying we don't need a special counsel, another Bob Mueller, independent of the DOJ.
That's what I'm arguing here. I mean, it's pretty much the same thing, apples to apples. If you're going to argue that you have not met the threshold,
correct,
by which you should be able
to appoint a special counsel.
Correct on that. You disagree with
meaning
that.
Meaning the Justice Department and the FBI have assets to investigate other aspects of the Justice Department and the FBI without a special counsel. These special counsels are dangerous, as Manafort has argued. They often get out on a tangent and indict people for things that have nothing to do with what their charge is.
Let me get to Manafort in a moment. Just one more question on this. If you're a Republican, right, and you're sitting in these hearings and you're getting all this evidence about text messages, et cetera,
right,
don't you think something smells and should be looked at?
Yes.
So that you and I and everybody else, yes, Republicans,
yes,
and Democrats have the trust in their government.
The reason, correct. That's the exact reason, Bill, because there must not only be justice, there must be the appearance of justice in what the FBI and the DOJ does. Look, the FBI agents are not choir boys. If they were, then bank robbers and terrorists and mobsters would roll over them. You don't want them to be choir boys. They have strong opinions. But if those political opinions are so strong that they interfere with their job, they should not be on that case.
All right. Paul Manafort's filed a civil complaint, right, against the case against him, the Department of Justice. Does he have a case?
In my opinion, no. And in my opinion, he has exacerbated his legal problems by doing that.
Made
them worse. If you think that the prosecutor who's prosecuting you lacks the jurisdiction, the legal authority to prosecute you, you bring that to the judge before whom your case is assigned. You do not try and drag another judge in on a civil case so that you can interrogate the prosecutor. That's the wrong
way. Can I take the other side of this?
Wrong time to
do it. So Paul Manafort's attorney is going to say, look, you're operating outside the legal definition of what a special counsel is all about. You're investigating stuff that is not relevant to Russia collusion, et cetera, et cetera. And you just said what a special counsel often does is they go into areas that are
right,
that where they should not.
You make that argument, to the judge in your case. You do not ask another judge to interfere with what's going on in your judge's courtroom. It just doesn't happen.
So could Manafort get a satisfactory answer based on the case against him now under the law?
The civil case that he's filed or the criminal? No, the civil case will be dismissed. That's how frivolous it is. It should have been a motion to dismiss the indictment in front of the criminal judge. She is in charge of all matters Manafort.
Do you think Manafort's in trouble here? Ultimately?
Yes. Yes. I think that the special prosecutor believes that Paul Manafort has information about the president of the United States, and he has indicted Manafort for essentially money laundering in the hopes that Manafort will say, Uncle, here's what I know about the president. Go easy on me. That's Bob Mueller's theory. Whether it's accurate or not, only time will tell.
Thank you, Judge.
You're welcome.
You're fresh.
Yeah.
Look at this guy, Smitty. I mean, put him in.
Always.